जय जय मा श्री अम्बे मा जगदम्बे 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 मा श्री शारदा मा जय जय 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 मा श्री मा जय 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 मा जय जय मा श्री अम्बे मा जगदम्बे 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 मा श्री शारदा मा जय जय 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 मा पुरानों की वाणी मुनियों ने
बोलते हैं सरस्वती माता, कोई बोलते हैं
लक्ष्मी माता, कोई बोलते हैं सरस्वती माता, कोई बोलते
बोलते हैं सरस्वती माता, कोई बोलते हैं
लक्ष्मी माता, कोई बोलते हैं सरस्वती माता, कोई बोलते हैं
तो है सारा जग के जननी गाते
Bye. कृष्ण भगवान की जय पवन सुत हनुमान की जय श्री अम्बे अम्बे मात की जय श्री महाकाली महालक्ष्मी महासरस्वती श्री दुर्गा मात की जय
ॐ ऐं सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय श्रीरामकृष्णाय नमः ॐ नमो नारायणाय डियर सिस्टर्स ब्रदर्स एंड लविंग चिल्ड्रन हिंदूज रिवियर मदर लक्ष्मी एज द गॉडेस ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरिटी Her endless blessings of wealth and virtues are always available to us. A verse in the Devi Mahatmyam says that Mother in the form of good fortune is in all of us. Om Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu Lakshmi Rupena Samsthita नमस्तस्यै 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 नमो नमः I bow again and again to the Devi who abides in all beings in the form of good fortune. So everyone has the opportunity to do good and be selfless as Mother and her power are in us. Sri Ramakrishna says, The wind of God's grace is blowing incessantly. Lazy sailors on the sea of life do not take advantage of it, but the active and strong always keep the sails of their minds unfurled to catch the favorable wind and thus reach their destination soon. Thus, God always encourages us to progress. Mother Lakshmi, The divine consort of Lord Vishnu showers her infinite grace in the form of spiritual and material wealth. Our scriptures portray virtues and vices as characters. We admire the virtuous people and try to cultivate their good qualities so that we can progress. The vices are the demons. These demons are always vanquished by the various powers of God. Thus, God bestows peace to all. The Devi Mahatmyam is an important scripture that praises God as Mother. The infinite forms of Shakti are glorified, but her three major aspects are Mother's Kali, Lakshmi and Saraswati. The Divine Mother destroys the evil forces to save and protect her devotees. In Chapter 3, Mother comes as Mother Lakshmi. Mother wages war with the demon Mahishasur. Mahishasur is so powerful that he can change to any form. He keeps moving from a buffalo to a lion to human being, then to an elephant, and back to his buffalo form until Mother Lakshmi destroys him. Mahishasura represents the restless mind. Desires are the root of an unsteady mind and are the main obstacles to spiritual progress. Unwanted passions lead also to jealousy, anger, hatred, and greed. The only way to overcome these vices is to purify our minds through spiritual disciplines. Prayer, japa, or the repetition of God's name, and meditation are the remedies for these maladies. Swami Vivekananda says, Ignorance is the cause of all the evil and misery that we see in the world. Let humankind have light. Let them be pure and spiritually strong and educated. Then alone will misery cease in this world. This means that when we realize the Atman within, when we realize that the same Atman is in everyone, then there will be no quarrels, no fights, no wars, and there will be peace on earth. Sri Ramakrishna says, the nearer you come to the Ganges, the more you will feel its coolness. You will feel completely soothed when you plunge into the river. Similarly, the nearer you come to God, the more peaceful you will feel. The modern word says, live and let live, which means let people live however they are living. Our revered Guruji used to say, live and help live. This is a very sublime thought. Swami Vivekananda too says, help whoever comes to you as much as lies in your power. Thus, the heart becomes pure and Shiva, who is in all, becomes manifest. When the Ramakrishna Math and Ramakrishna Mission began, Swami Vivekananda wanted to serve humanity and he said, we must build schools and hospitals. But the devotees said, we do not have any money. How will we build all of these? Swamiji replied, do not worry about money. It will fall from the heavens. Wealth is a grace from Mother Lakshmi, who showers it on all those who work selflessly to do good to humanity. Two important ideas about Mother Lakshmi are expressed from ancient times. Firstly, the lamp in every home is referred to as Lakshmi. This divine idea reminds us of the soul or the Atman in each of us. About 4 decades ago, the lamp or Lakshmi was lit in every Hindu home, every morning and evening, and everyone chanted this prayer. Om Asatoma Sadgamaya Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya. This meaning is, O Lord, lead me from untruth to truth. From darkness of ignorance, O Lord, lead me to the light of knowledge. And from death, lead me to immortality. We become immortal by knowing God, by knowing about the Atman, also by meditating on the lamp that does not flicker. We learn concentration, our minds become calm, and we feel peaceful. Unfortunately, today few homes light the lamp. Secondly, every woman was regarded as Lakshmi. When a little girl was born in a home, the elders would say, Lakshmi has come to our home. These inspiring thoughts kindle respect for women. Mother Lakshmi grants spiritual wealth, which is the best wealth, since it brings eternal happiness. Her boons in the form of grain symbolize nourishment and prosperity, which are very essential to life. Everyone requires funds to live. We have to work very hard to earn a living. Yet, we must not forget to pray every morning and evening. Once M. Mahendranath Gupta, who was the recorder of the Gospel of Sri Ramakrishna, asked the master. He said, Sir, may I make an effort to earn more money? Sri Ramakrishna replied, yes, it is permissible to do so to maintain a religious family. You may try to increase your income, but in an honest way. The goal of life is not the earning of money, but the service of God. Money is not harmful if it is devoted to the service of God. To be able to give in charity is a great blessing from Mother Lakshmi. The more we give, the more we get. Our revered Guruji used to say, on birthdays and holy days, you should give in charity, for this is worship of the living God. Sri Sharda Devi was very thrifty and used money carefully. She was neither lavish nor miserly. She did her best to save and then help others. One who is stable in mind is considered more prosperous than one who has much wealth but is fickle-minded. Our scriptures describe Mother Saraswati's divine qualities and the virtues that she bestows on her devotees. One verse says, O Goddess, you are the embodiment of secular and sacred knowledge. One acquires a family, wealth, and food by your blessings. Those who have been blessed by you, O Mother, are free from disease and pain. O Divine Mother, those on whom you bestow your kindness become wise and prosperous. And another hymn says, I want that Lakshmi who stays permanently with me. If by receiving Lakshmi, in this case it will mean wealth, I am made to forget God, then I do not want that Lakshmi. In other words, I want the wealth of spirituality. Qualities like compassion, unselfishness, and the ability to offer selfless service, which will help me blossom into a divine being. In us are all these noble qualities which we have to manifest to make us worthy of receiving Mother's infinite grace. Sri Ramakrishna says, I could have paved the streets of Kamarpukur with gold if I so desired. Kamarpukur is Master's birthplace. So Master says he could have paved the streets of Kamarpukur with gold. But how will that help the people of my village? They will be engrossed in worldliness and will forget God. In recent years, many people are getting retrenched. The COVID pandemic has made the situation worse as people are losing their jobs. Yet, we must not lose hope. Use your skills to be self-sufficient. Never be despondent. When we take one step towards doing anything noble, God takes 10 steps towards us to help us fulfill all righteous deeds. Mother Lakshmi encourages us on the path of dharma when she states all the qualities that are conducive to receiving her grace and those that make her abandon us. Mother says, one who is humble and respectful to God is my favorite. I love to live with people who are well-spoken, efficient, religious, respectful to the aged, and are truthful. I discard the quarrelsome, lazy, dirty, and careless persons. I reside with one who is not prone to anger. I live with those who serve their spouses well, who are forgiving, simple, and of good character. I never leave homes where all are treated with respect. I do not live in places where there is violence, theft, and deception. I do not stay with those who do not arrange their household properly and are always speaking against their spouses. I am not in the home of those who like to always be in the homes of others, who have no patience and sleep excessively. These details enable us to cultivate the right qualities to receive Mother's grace. Mother Lakshmi pervades the entire universe. In a dialogue between Mother Lakshmi and Parvati, Mother Lakshmi says, O Maheshwari, I am Lord Vishnu's Parashakti, his great power. I appear in many forms. As the earth, I support the rivers, mountains, and seas. I produce food and nourish living beings. In the form of Surya, that is the sun, and Agni, fire, I give light to the whole universe and ripen crops. As air, I am the life. I bless householders with progress by making them charitable and religious. I give the ultimate bliss of God realization to the wise and liberate them. The whole world is my expression. Very beautiful words for us to see how Mother Lakshmi lives on earth, how we can see her power manifest. The arati that we sing to the Divine Mother during Navaratri fills our hearts with love and devotion. The last verse says, O Mother, we do not ask for wealth or riches, nor do we ask for silver or gold. All we ask for is a little place in your heart. O the one who showers compassion on all. In other words, O Mother, please do not forget us. Remember us and always be there to save and protect us. By cultivating devotion, we develop an intimate relationship with Mother and derive great joy in listening to her glories. Chanting Mother's divine names are like the churning process through which we can purify our minds. When our minds are filled with holy thoughts, then there is no place for selfishness or enmity. Regular prayers enable us to feel Mother's divine presence. Let us use this auspicious time to increase our japa and meditation. We can be in Mother's holy company by glorifying her through hymns and devotional songs. During this auspicious time of Navaratri, we pray to Mother Lakshmi to bless us with all the spiritual wealth and virtues that we need to fulfill our purpose in life. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
Vishnu Vinashini Keshnu Nute Bhagavad वासुते। ओम श्री महाकाली महालक्ष्मी महासरस्वती श्री दुर्गा माते की जय।
ओम अथ महालक्ष्मी अष्टक स्तोत्रम्।
नमस्तेस्तु महामाये श्रीविग्रहे सुरपूजिते शंखचक्र गदाहस्ते महालक्ष्मी नमोस्तुते। महालक्ष्मी नमोस्तुते। नमस्ते गरुडायुधे कोलासुर
presence of our beloved Mother Lakshmi in our hearts. A verse from the Devi Mahatmyam says, "When called to mind in a difficult pass, you remove fear from every person. When called to mind by those in happiness, you bestow a mind still further pious. Which goddess but you, O dispeller of poverty, pain and fear, has an ever sympathetic heart for helping everyone. We comprehend and meditate upon Mahalakshmi, the goddess of all success. May that goddess enlighten our intellect so that we may realize the supreme truth. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
जनन पर पीर पड़ी है भारी दानव दल पर टूट पड़ो मा करके सिंह सवारी साथो सिंह पे तू बलिहारी है दस भुजा वो वाली दुष्टों को दूरी तो संग आरती ओ मैया हम सब उतारे तेरी आरती ओ मैया हम सब उतारे तेरी आरती माँ बेटे का है इस जग में परा ही निर्मल दाता माँ बेटे का है इस जग में परा ही निर्मल दाता पूज कपूज सुन है पर ना माता सुने कुमाता सबके अमृत बरसाने वाली सबको हर्षाने वाली नैया भवर से वो तारती ओ मैया हम सब उतारे तेरी आरती ओ मैया हम सब उतारे तेरी आरती नहीं मांगते धन और दौलत ना चांदी ना सोना नहीं मांगते धन और दौलत ना चांदी ना सोना हम तो मांगे माँ तेरे मन में एक छोटा सा कोना सबके करुणा बरसाने वाली विपता मिटाने वाली सतियों के सत को आरती ओ मैया हम सब उतारे तेरी आरती ओ मैया हम सब उतारे तेरी आरती अम्बे तू है जगदम्बे काली जय दुर्गे कप्पर वाली तेरे ही गुण गाए ब्रह्मा विष्णु महेश्वरा ओ मैया हम सब उतारे तेरी आरती ओ मैया हम सब उतारे तेरी आरती अम्बे जय जय जगदम्बे काली चंडी के अम्बे जय जय जगदम्बे शारदा चंडी के अम्बे जय जय जगदम्बे काली चंडी के अम्बे जय जय जगदम्बे शारदा चंडी के ओ मैया अम्बिके ओ मैया चंडी के ओ मैया शारदा ओ मैया कपरवाणि तेरे ही गुण गाए ब्रह्मा विष्णु महेश्वरा ओ मैया हम सब उतारे तेरी आरती ओ मैया हम सब उतारे तेरी आरती ओ मैया
स्वामी जी की जय सर्व ऋषि मुनियों की जय पार्वती पतये हर हर महादेव की जय श्री महाकाली महालक्ष्मी महासरस्वती श्री दुर्गा